I've waited 100 years, and I'd wait 1,000,000 more for you. Nothing prepared me for the privilege of being yours, would do. If I had only felt the warmth within your touch, if I had only seen how you smile when you blush, or how you curl your lip when you concentrate enough, I would have known what I was living for.
It's Friday. It's Morning Coffee. I'm Rick Alexander. I appreciate y'all for listening. I wanted to say just a super heartfelt thank you. In the last 6 months, this show has continued to grow month over month. I think we've only had one down month in the last six, and it was barely. Since I launched Morning Coffee, it seems to be resonating because we continue to grow. And I think the best compliment you could give me is to share this message with somebody else. I feel like this idea of an alternative conversation to the facts that we're always given is just really, really important. And so I just wanted to say a really heartfelt thank you. I really appreciate your support every time you reach out. Again, the greatest compliment you could give me is to share it with somebody who you think could use this message. So one of the natural themes that's kind of emerged this week is the idea that A lot of people are living really authentic lives, and a lot of people are bored, and a lot of people don't really know what it is that they want to do. And the reason I love this show so much is because it gives us an opportunity to refocus and figure out what we might want. It gives us a new narrative, because the one that we're spoon-fed throughout our whole lives is really designed to make us a cog in a wheel, and it's not necessarily designed to give us some kind of sense of well-being or satisfaction. Which is why I believe so strongly in this. One of the things that happens as a result of us trying to be of service to everybody and trying to do the right thing, and you know, we tie nobility into that idea as well, that it's like it's noble to sacrifice yourself for other people. But one of the things that happens is that we don't end up ever refilling our own cup. We don't find the activities and the things that we need that inherently give us energy and give us vitality. But the truth is, if you continue to give yourself to everything around you and you have nothing left for yourself, not only is your sense of contentment, your sense of well-being diminished highly, you're also not of service to the people around you like you could be, because you're not the best version of you. And you know, if you think about this, like if you think about it in your car, you wouldn't run your car out of gas. Actually, some of you in college definitely do this, but it's not a good way to live your life. If you run your car out of gas every time you need to refill it, how awful does that make your life? Like, how inconvenient is that? How terrible is that to try to overcome if you were to just have to run it out every time you got gas? You would end up in some really weird positions. Well, same thing with your life. Like, if you never refill your, if you wait till your cup is empty to start asking yourself, like, oh, what do I need? What? Oh, I don't even know. And you don't know. You just end up going around with an empty cup. The reality is, as you're going through life, you should try to clue yourself in on the activities that give you energy. Now, there's things in your personality that could really hint at what some of these things are. So introversion versus extroversion is one of those things. That's kind of how I teach that in the Clarity Academy. When you do a personality test and it says, like, you're 70% extrovert, okay, well, then you know there's 30% of you that needs time to yourself. And that might look like journaling. That might look like coffee in the morning. That might look like reading in the morning. But you have to do the things that you know that you need. And if you don't know what you need, then you're going to continue to run out of gas. Your cup is going to be empty. And then you're not going to know where to turn for answers. And it's going to feel overwhelming. It's going to feel like you're never ahead. You're 2 inches below the surface of the water. I feel like that is the best analogy for life, because so many of us are living in this perpetual state of, it just feels like we're drowning to the possibilities and the obligation and the responsibility and the expectations. And they're all getting stacked on top of us all the time. The reality is, you would be so much, not only for your own contentment, but for the people around you, which I like that, because this is sort of emerged as a theme this week as well. The people around you are going to get a better version of you. You're actually going to be of better service to the world if you figure out what it is that you need. And honestly, what this looks like tactically for you is just thinking about the different things that you could do in your life that would give you energy. What are the things that you do that take energy, but then once you finish, give you more? As an example, when I finish the coaching calls for the Clarity Academy at night, I know for sure I pretty much have to always go for a run after I finish that because I have so much energy, because I'm so on fire about the material and about teaching. And when I see people like sort of come to their own breakthroughs and have conclusions and figure something out about themselves that they've been struggling with, that just fires me up. And so it gives me energy. And so I think the more of your life, the more of the things in your life that you can participate in that not only take energy, but also give it back to you, the more content you're going to be, and also the more meaning you're going to drive in your life. And then further, the more of service you're going to be to the people around you. So my question for you today is like, what are the things that give you energy? What are the things that you need that are individual to you, you know? Because the thing about all of this is this whole life is a very subjective psychological experience. It's not, there isn't a one size fit all, there isn't an objective, and that makes it really hard because it can be intellectually exhausting to look around at your life and figure out what you actually need. And when you compare that with you trying to exist in this society that's intellectually lazy, Q, CNN, Fox News, most regular curriculums, like a lot of the narrative that we're fed in life is intellectually lazy. And so when you want something beyond that, when it's not, the status quo isn't satisfying, it's exhausting to figure out what it is you need. But the thing that I always follow up every time I say that, and look, I'm in this journey. I'm well aware of how much of a struggle it can be to figure out what you actually want in your life. The thing is there really any more noble of a pursuit? Is there anything better that you could spend your time on than figuring out the things that give you vitality? I would say probably not, right? Because you're going to show up in a much better way, and those are two very different lives. So I love that this theme has popped up this week of like just sort of searching for authenticity, because it's really at the heart of all of my messages. It's really at the heart of everything. All of my whole body of work is about figuring out, it's about rejecting the status quo if you're unhappy with it. So, you know, look around, figure out what it is that you need, what activities give you energy, and then ask yourself, when was the last time that you did something just for you? I'll wait. I think in a lot of situations, we look around and we look back on our lives and we realize like when we don't know what it was all for, it's because we didn't give ourselves enough of what we actually needed. And so you have an opportunity right now going forward to really start taking stock of those things and the things that you need, the things that give you energy, so that you can show up better for the people around you. And you'd be surprised, like 30 minutes in the morning might be all you need. Like that's all I need. I'm pretty much extrovert, but I need 30 minutes in the morning to journal, to drink coffee, to collect my thoughts. And then I'm ready to actually give something to the world. And when I don't do that, I feel like I'm running way low on gas, right? Like I'm running on E. The reality is that you can't wait for your cup to be empty before you try to figure it out, because then it feels hopeless, feels overwhelming, and you feel lost. Figure out the things that you need and give them to yourself. Give yourself that gift so that the world can get the best of you and not a shell of who you actually are. You guys have an amazing weekend. I'll talk to you on Monday on Morning Coffee. I got my ticket for the long way round. Two bottle of whiskey for the way. And I sure would like some sweet company. And I'm leaving tomorrow, what do you say? When I'm gone, when I'm gone. You're gonna miss me when I'm gone. You're gonna miss me by my hair. You're gonna miss me everywhere. Oh, you're gonna miss me when I'm gone. When I'm gone, when I'm gone. You're gonna miss me when I'm gone. You're gonna miss me by my walk. You're gonna miss me by my talk. Oh, you're gonna miss me when I'm gone.
miss me by my talk. Oh, you're gonna miss me when